This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to find the surface area of a cone. I'll start out by explaining how we derive the general formula for surface area, and then I'll go on and do two problems. One where we're given what's called the slant height of the cone, and another where we're not given it. So let's get started. I've drawn a picture of a cone here, and I've labeled the two dimensions that we're very often given. One is going to be the radius of the cone. We're going to use an R for radius. And the other is the slant height. The slant height is the distance from the base of the cone, the edge of the cone, the edge of the circle that makes up the base, to the top of the cone. And typically we use the letter L for that. Sometimes you'll see an S, but very often it's going to be an L. Now, to understand what I'm looking for, I've cut out these two pieces of paper. I've got a circle here, and its radius is labeled R. That's going to be the base of a cone. And then I've got a sector of a circle, and I've labeled the radius of that sector as L. Now, if I take this sector, I can form it into the top part of the cone, and I could place it directly over the circle, and I would have both parts of the cone. So we're looking for the area of each of these two figures. Now, the area of the base is going to be fairly easy to find. That's just the area of a circle. So we can start writing the formula. The general formula for the surface area of a cone is going to be the area of that base, which would just be pi r squared, plus the area of the sector. And that's what we've got to figure out. Now, here's how we're going to do it. First, let's make believe that instead of this being a sector, it's an entire circle. If it was an entire circle, we would know its surface area fairly easily. That would be pi times its radius squared, and its radius is L. So the area for the entire circle is pi L squared. But I haven't got an entire circle, I've only got a sector. So what I'm going to do is form a fraction. The fraction is going to have as its numerator the arc of the sector, the length of the round portion of the sector, over what would be the circumference of the entire circle if the sector was an entire circle. So let's do the circumference of the entire circle part first. Well, circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. Instead of r, we'll use l. So if this sector was complete, it would be 2 pi l. That would be its circumference. I want to find just the part that we have. Now remember, the arc of that sector fits perfectly onto the smaller circle which forms the base. So that means the length of that arc is the same as the circumference of the smaller circle. Well, I know the circumference of the smaller circle. That's 2 pi r. So now I've got this ratio. It's the ratio of the arc of the sector to what would be the entire circle if the sector were complete. If I take that ratio and multiply it by the area of what would be the entire circle, then what I'm going to get is the area of the sector. Now, I can simplify this multiplication problem quite a bit. I've got the fraction 2 pi r over 2 pi l. So obviously I can cancel out the 2s, I can cancel out the pi's, and I've got an l in the denominator and an l squared. So I can cancel out that l and take the l squared and just make it l to the first power. So now I've got r times pi l. That's going to give me the surface area for this sector, the other part of the cone. That's very often switched around into pi r l. Doesn't really matter what order you write them in. So now I've got a general formula for the surface area of a cone. It's going to be pi r squared, which is the area of the base, plus pi r l, which is the area of the sector that makes up the side of the cone. So let's take that formula and apply it to a couple of problems. In this first problem, I'm given the radius of the base, that's 2 centimeters, and L, which is the slant height, that's going to be 5 centimeters. So I'll write down that formula again. Surface area equals pi r squared plus pi r L. I will just plug the numbers in. So we'll have pi times 2 squared plus pi times r, which is 2, times l, which is 5. 2 squared is 4, so that's 4 pi, plus 2 times 5 is 10, so that's 10 pi. I can add those two numbers together, and I get 14 pi. I'm dealing in centimeters, so that's going to be square centimeters. And if you want to, you could take, instead of pi, use a rough estimate for it, 3.14, multiply that by 14, and get a fairly close approximation of the surface area of the cone. If you want something more accurate, you could put this into your calculator. Okay, let's do another problem where we're not given the slant height. So for this cone, the radius once again is 2, it's 2 feet. And we're given the height of the cone. That's the distance from the center of the base directly to the top of the cone. Now, those two lines, the height of the cone and the radius of the base, form a right angle. So we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find out what L is going to equal. So L, which would be the which is the slant height and is the hypotenuse of that right angle, that right triangle, L is going to equal the square root of the height squared plus the radius squared. I'll plug the numbers in. The height is 3, so I'm going to have the square root of 3 squared, let's just call that 9, plus 2 squared, which is 4, so I've got the square root of 9 plus 4. So L equals the square root of 13. And now we'll write the formula and plug in the numbers. So the surface area is pi r squared plus pi r l. R is 2. So that's going to be 2 squared plus pi times the radius, which is 2, times L, which is the square root of 13. I'm just going to take that 2 squared and make it a 4. And now I can rearrange this a little bit and call that pi times the expression 4 plus 2 times the square root of 13. Okay, and once again, you could put this into your calculator and find out fairly specifically what the surface area of the cone is going to be. Now, as with a lot of things in math, you could take this general formula for the area and memorize it. Surface area equals pi r squared plus pi r l. But math is more about understanding than it is about memorization. So even though you might want to memorize this, you should probably make sure you understand how we derive the formula. Once you understand how to derive the formula, if you forget the specific formula, you can just make it up once again for yourself. Okay? So I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.